morning, everybody, and happy Friday. TGIF, Tiff.
Good morning. Good morning to you all. I'm happy it's Friday.
Yeah, I'm very happy for the weekend, too. And you and I text a lot, so I kind of know the answer to this. But do you use punctuation in text, you know, like periods and question marks and exclamation points?
Yes, and I don't know anyone who doesn't.
Okay. I know three people extremely well who use none, and that's all three of my children. In fact, they don't even use capital letters.
Well, now you know you failed as a parent because that's barbaric.
Isn't it? I know. Oh, trust me. I've known for a very long time that I failed as a parent. That's why you're their mom, right?
Right. So yep, still much better parenting.
New York Post had a fascinating article, and they're so over the two spaces after a period. That's so yesterday.
I get the two-space thing.
Yeah, the two-space thing, okay, is like long over, but also punctuation. So there's a writer of a book on the digital age and digital etiquette, and it said, and the quote was, only old people or troubled souls put periods at the end of every sentence
when
texting. Yes. In fact, get this tip. Victoria Turk, who is the author of Kill Reply All, says that while older texters consider it polite to put a period at the end of a sentence, for example, younger digital natives consider it a form of aggression and extremely uncool.
Periods or exclamation points?
Period. So if you say to somebody, you're annoying, period, that's like screaming at them. That's like putting it in all caps to them.
What if you just say, how are you, period?
You would do, how are you, no capital H on the how are you? You do just a U and there'd be no question mark.
I don't like that. Especially if there's only one space, then it's just one long run-on sentence.
Oh, yeah. And my kids have tons of them. But the thing is, and this is what I think is most, I don't know if it's impressive or shocking or disturbing, is how brief young people can be via text. I can send my kids, I'm serious, a text like this long on a phone,
yeah,
and I will get a response that might say like NVM, like never mind or something.
Oh, my. Well, yeah, because you just like basically nagged at them with a long response.
How'd you know?
Well, I will say, I mean, I've got a lot of young nieces and nephews that I text, and they still all use punctuation, but the youngest one that I text is 20. So she uses text, but she barely replies. So
right.
I mean, getting a reply out of that one is like,
That's a thing.
You must have won the lottery and she wants some money or something.
Yeah, and maybe your nieces and nephews just aren't cool. I mean, if they're using punctuation, maybe.
Right. Maybe
totally
that's
totally kidding.
That's crazy. Honestly, it would drive me nuts. And especially, I'll say this, if I were a grandparent trying to text my grandchild, because I'm always amazed at how quickly my mom has picked up texting and the fact that she'll use emojis now. I don't think she can send GIFs yet, you know, like little picture things,
yeah,
but she'll use emojis. She uses them right. She does all that fun stuff. And she's really good. And she even knows some abbreviations, but I think that is a huge thing when a grandparent can text their grandchild and communicate with each other with that age gap via text.
Yeah, I think so too. And my parents do it with six grandkids. They never complain about brief texts. They just, I think, expect a reply. And my kids
right,
kind of know if you're expecting a birthday present, Christmas presents, you got a reply. But they also still do handwritten notes for birthday gifts and things like that, which I think is important.
Yeah. Really, you're right. It's kind of a form of etiquette in how you text. I think we could go on and on and on. We obviously are out of time, so we'll put it out to you, everybody. Tell us what you think on Facebook. I want to hear from you. How important is punctuation when texting? I hope everybody agrees with us.
I think it's a fantastic question. And notice we put a question mark at the end of our sound off question.
Sure did.
Because it is a question.
How.
Yeah.